It's a nice day for it. I haven't surfed in a while, and I'm a novice at best, but it was good to get out in the waves. The Bar Boys are setting up a shop here in Maroubra.
We all need a sanctuary. Just as we may subconsciously wish to travel to the stars, we may have a subconscious desire to return to the sanctuary of the womb. The womb of creation itself, perhaps, a place of safety and sanctity. The vaginal-like interior of the church may play on these possible desires. The ceiling within the St. Andrew's Cathedral has both the vaginal inner sanctum Vesica Pisces shapes along with the stars in the heavens. After the surf at Maroubra, I decided to go back to Centennial Park and pick up where we left off and do some more filming.
From the Centennial Park Cafe and Restaurant, we'll go now to this monument here on the hill devoted to rugby. So let's have a closer look at this monument. Walking up to one of the eight lions that surrounds this octagonal structure, and we can see Milne Bros, Sydney, reminding us that there is no doubt a Masonic influence on the sculpture, which is there's no doubt about that. So let's it's titled We Won, and we can see the inscription on there. This is an old monument, first erected in 1893 by Sir Henry Parkes. So around the stem of this monument we can see these infants reaching up for this rugby ball. Now the rugby ball perhaps represents something of enlightenment, perhaps. So here are the infants perhaps coming in from the heavens, for want of another word, through this gate or doorway. Some doorway symbolism here. Here they come pouring through. Here they come, the infants, on their way through that doorway. We'll move around. Here's a shot of them reaching up towards, in a pyramidal fashion, towards the rugby ball, which is no doubt symbolic of enlightenment. And here is another panel. We see them reaching down. We see that doorway symbolism in there once more. Let's just have a look up further here up the monument. We see the inscription We Won, and we'll back up, and there is the lad on the top with the rugby ball. His boots on and all the rest of it. Interestingly, on this child, we can see a lion's head sort of draped over the head of the child and down around the shoulders, with the paws here coming around onto the abdomen. This child is reaching up for the Romanesque crests, the Roman symbolism is always popping up. This one is writing or taking notes and observing, perhaps writing history. This one is sounding a horn, or perhaps an audible frequency that is being heard perhaps by the figures up in the top here before they come through that doorway. So I'm just having a little go at this as I walk around it, but perhaps with more research, more ideas will come to light. And now we'll go and visit the Federation Pavilion here in Centennial Park, Sydney. So I've just got back from the surf at Maroubra. Just thought I'd take another visit to Centennial Park to show you guys something. Now, so we've got the flagpoles here of Joaquin and Boaz, and we have an obelisk shape here where they are set into. Before we get into the middle of this obelisk shape, we can see a ribbon decoration on this bench structure, and then onto the ground and over onto this next bench. Within it we can read, "The crimson thread of kinship runs through us all, Henry Parkes." Here is a shot of another crimson thread at the Mercure Hotel at Railway Square in Sydney. You'll also notice the all-seeing eye-esque shape, and I will discuss this hotel in more detail in the future. So we have this obelisk shape reminding us of a woman, perhaps a womanly shape. In the center here we have some inscription: "The Federation of Australia, 1st of January 1901. This was where the Federation of Australia actually happened, at the site where this new pavilion is now. There are further inscriptions on here which you can read, and this was opened on the 1st of January 1988, so this is quite recent, quite a recent structure. So we have the circle here, which could be a sephira from the Kabbalah, and that could say go up in an invisible sort of a way between these two outer pillars, severity and mercy, and that would make for the Kabbalah. So if we now go over here, we are walking down three steps. So those spinning around, those three steps are reminiscent of the three steps that lead up to the Grand Master's chair in a Masonic lodge. And we will turn around now. There are flagpoles that surround in a round circle around the pavilion. So we have a circle and an outer circle, and in the middle lies the pavilion. So let's go and have a look at the pavilion. One thing I'd like to say straight out about this pavilion is that the top of it looks, it reminds me of a sort of flying saucer, if you will. It looks like it's perhaps on a launch pad, dare I say it. There is a circular shape that goes around the outside of the monument just here. This monument is a circle or a dot within a circle, which is quite Masonesque as well. If we look up at the writing here, we see Eden, and further around there are other words, so we'll just have a look at those.
The exterior inscription reads, Mammon or Millennial Eden. From the Parklands website, we can read. The words are a paraphrase of questions posed in the poem Australia by Bernard O'Dowd, written in 1901. A new domain for mammon to infest, or lurks millennial Eden neath your face. The paraphrase was suggested by Professor Manning Clark, who believed that the poem reflected the principal obsession of the intellectual community at the time. Will Australia become a country of corrupt, ill-gotten wealth, or will we create a paradise that will last for 1,000 years? In an article titled Esoteric Australia within the New Dawn magazine, we can read on further. So reading. By taking the way of materialism, Australians cut themselves off from the subtle influences of the spirit and cosmic destiny. Manning Clark, Australia's greatest historian, expressed the spiritual crisis of modern Australia when he said, "The decline of faith begat nihilism, and nihilism begat hedonism. It looked as though, in the contest between Mammon and Millennial Eden, Mammon had won. The dreams of all those who had migrated to the great Southland had evaporated. The Aborigine had been corrupted and debased by contact with the white man. The voices of the Catholic who had spoken of a land dedicated to the Holy Spirit, the Dutch Protestants who had called for the discovery of a land that they could yield uncommonly large profit, and the pleas of the followers of the Enlightenment with their faith in human predictability had all dropped from a roar to a whisper. Mammon had won. Mammon had infected the ancient continent of Australia. The dreams of humanity had ended in an age of ruins." Yet, in every generation, in every nation, there is always a remnant of men and women who have not succumbed fully to the negative earthly bonds. They are the silent ones who stand among the ruins of the modern era, living testimonies to the higher world of the spirit. The ability of any nation or people to realize their spiritual potential and partake in the dawn of a new golden age depends on the vitality of this remnant.
So we'll now go and have a look at the center, or the inside of this pavilion here in Centennial Park here in Sydney. It's closed at the moment, but I'll just put the camera through here. So there is an obelisk type structure in the middle. It's hexagonal in shape. It has the six states of Australia, West Australia, South Australia, Victoria, Queensland, New South Wales and Tasmania. If we look around the floor, you can see the tangents or the lines coming off that hexagonal shape, perhaps reflective of the fractal nature or expansive nature, if you will, of our universe. We'll now go to the ceiling, and in the center of the ceiling there is this metallic shape, and emanating from that down we can see an illustration, and within this illustration there is a sun type figure, or perhaps a Stargate type figure, reminding us of that, of the target symbol. And we'll just draw back from that. There is also this figure here. He has some writing in there, charity, hope and faith. Signed down at the foot there by GB, the illustrator. So And that shape sort of tapers up into the metal shape, so it has a metal tip, if you will. There is also a rainbow shape doing the same thing, sort of emanating up into that metallic structure as well. So it's perhaps got a metal tip as well, which is a feature that I can show you from elsewhere, or you may recall.